Hello learners, welcome back to my channel Shraddha's Physics. In this lecture we will discuss on the Lagrange application to the single particle in space. Now let us start our topic with the Lagrange application to a particle falling freely under gravity. That is, this is the single particle in space we can say. Let us consider a particle of mass m. A particle of mass m, falling freely under gravity, such that we will consider the x and y axis, they are taken on the surface of the earth, such that x and y axis are considered on the earth's surface and z axis is taken along vertically upward direction. Now we can write the kinetic energy for this particle. So the kinetic energy will be, that is equal to, suppose T, that is equal to 1/2 mv², or this can be written as equal to T equal to 1/2 mvx² plus vy² plus vz², because since it is a single particle and we can consider it to be three dimensional system, so the velocity will be equal to vx² plus vy² plus vz². We can put in place of v², and also we can write this is also equal to 1/2 mx² plus y² plus z². Because in place of the velocity we can write the rate of change of the displacement. So this x dot means dx/dt, and dx/dt is nothing but the vx, and so on. So this is the kinetic energy. Now similarly we can write the expression for the potential energy. So the potential energy, v, that is equal to mgh, or we can say that the height is here z, so this will be mg into z. So we can write the Lagrangian function. So the Lagrangian function, that is L, Lagrangian, L equal to T minus V. So in place of this kinetic energy T, we can write this will be 1/2 mx² plus y² plus z² and here this will be minus mgz. So this is the Lagrangian. Now you can write the Lagrangian equation. So we can write the Lagrangian equation of motion, Lagrange's equation will be, this is, you know, d by dt of dou l divided by dou qk dot minus dou l by dou qk, that is equal to 0. And in this place qk, we have the coordinates x, y and z. These are the coordinates. Now we have three equations here. So for one equation I will write this will be d by dt of dou l by dou x dot minus dou l by dou x, that is equal to 0. This is for x coordinate. And similarly for y coordinate I will write d by dt of dou l by dou y dot minus dou l by dou y, that is equal to 0. And similarly for those z axis we can write, or the z coordinate we can write, this will be d by dt of dou l by dou z dot minus dou l by dou z, that is equal to 0. So these are the three Lagrangian equations. Okay, now first of all, what we will calculate? We will calculate this for this equation, first equation, I will calculate dou l by dou x and dou l by dou x dot. Let me write the equation again, the Lagrangian L equal to t minus b, and this is equal to 1 by 2 m x dot square plus y dot square plus z dot square minus mgz. Okay, so you can see here the Lagrangian equal to L equal to this much. So here from this expression we can calculate dou L by dou x first. So let me calculate. Dou L by dou x will be equal to dou L by dou x, that is equal to 0, because here you can see in this Lagrangian expression no s term is present. So simply dou L by dou x will be 0. But when I will calculate dou L by dou x dot, then you can see for this, if I take the partial derivative for this x dot, this will be x dot square will be equal to 2x dot. So 1 by 2 m into 2x dot, then 2 to get cancelled, this will be equal to m into x dot. Now if I put this value in this Lagrangian equation, that is 1, so this will becomes d by dt of, we can write d by dt of dou l by dou x dot is your mx dot minus 0, that is equal to 0. Or simply we can write for this, this will be equal to d by dt of mx dot is nothing but mx double dot, this is equal to 0. Or simply we can write it as x double dot, that is equal to 0. Okay. And similarly, if I will calculate for the y coordinate, you can see here, for the y coordinate, if I will calculate, this is my, suppose second equation, this one. So we have to calculate dou l by dou y. So here dou l by dou y will be equal to dou l by dou y, that will be equal to 0, because here no y term is present in this Lagrangian. So dou l by dou y equal to 0. Again, if you calculate dou l by dou y dot, so dou l by dou y dot will be equal to, this is the term for y dot square, so this will be 2 into 1 by 2, that will be m into y dot, so this will be simply m y dot. Now if you put this in equation 2, this equation, so this will be d by dt of m y dot, so this will be d by dt of m y dot minus this 0, that is equal to 0. Or simply we can write, this will be m y double dot, this will be m y double dot, that is equal to 0. Or simply y double dot equal to 0. Now here we will see for the z coordinate. Now you can see here for the z coordinate we have to again calculate. This is your, suppose equation 3, you have to calculate dou l by dou z. Now here check the Lagrangian. So here the Lagrangian is L equal to, here you can see the z term is present, that is mgz. So the derivative of minus mgz will be minus mg. So here dou l by dou z, that is equal to minus mg. And also we will calculate dou l by dou z dot. So the value of dou l by dou z dot will be equal to, you can see here from this expression, the z dot square derivative will be 2 into z dot. So 1 by 2 into 2 get cancelled, this will be simply m z dot. So here this value will be m into z dot. Now if we'll put this in this equation, so this will be d by dt of m z dot minus, this minus minus becomes plus mg, that is equal to 0. Now we can also write this as, this implies m z double dot plus mg, that is equal to 0. And if I take common m, then this will be z double dot plus g, that is equal to 0, because 0 by m is also 0. So we have calculated three equation, that is, one is z double dot plus g equal to 0, another one is y double dot equal to 0 and x double dot equal to 0. And also if you want to solve this, you can solve it further. That is, here you can see that d by dt of, in this expression, let me draw clearly, in this expression particularly, so here d by dt of mx dot equal to 0. So d by dt of mx dot equal to 0 means we can write mx dot equal to some constant. So this constant is suppose a, let us see, or we can directly write from this expression, since x double dot equal to 0, we can write x dot equal to some constant, suppose a. So from this x dot equal to a, we can write this will be dx by dt, that is equal to a. Or if I will take dt onto the right hand side, then this will be simply dx will be equal to a into dt. And if I will integrate now, then this will be x equal to a into t, and so integration constant suppose c, or let me write suppose b. So this is our final expression for x, that is equal to a t plus b. And similarly, if you will solve for the y double dot equal to 0, then for that equation also we can write this will be, if I will compare this x double dot equal to 0, this is x equal to a t plus b, where a and b are some constant. Similarly, when y double dot equal to 0, for that we can write this will be y will be equal to suppose some constant c into t plus d, where c and d are your constant. So basically there are three equations you will find, that is x double dot equal to 0 or x equal to a t plus b, y double dot 0 or y equal to c t plus d, and z double dot plus g equal to 0. Now also one more thing, in case of a free particle, suppose in case of a free particle, you may consider the potential to be 0. Let me write it here. Suppose in case of free particle, in some terms you may choose, for a free particle you may choose potential equal to 0. So simply, when this potential will be 0, you may write the Lagrangian to be t minus b, or this is simply t, or this t equal to the kinetic energy, this will be 1 by 2 m x dot square plus y dot square plus z dot square. In this expression, if you will calculate the Lagrangian equation of motion, you can see here from this expression, in this equation 1, you don't need this term, that is mgz. This term you will not need, this minus mgz term that is present in the Lagrangian here, because of the potential we have considered here, potential energy mgz. So this term only required when you will take dou L by dou Z. For that expression, you will need this component. Now you can check here, the first equation will remain same, the second equation will remain same, and only for this third one, you may see here, this dou L by dou Z, since here the potential we will consider is 0, let for the free particle, if I will consider the potential equal to 0, then in that case, Z term is absent. So dou L by dou Z is 0 here. And simply dou L by dou Z dot, this will be equal to M Z dot. As in this case also, here you can see dou L by dou Z dot equal to M Z dot. So simply also here dou L by dou Z dot equal to M Z dot. And here if I will apply the Lagrangian equation of motion, that is d by dt of dou L by dou Z dot, that is equal to M Z dot minus dou L by dou Z, which is equal to 0, and this is equal to 0. Or we can say that d by dt of mz dot, that is equal to 0. Or we can simply write it as mz double dot, that is equal to 0. Or simply this will be z double dot equal to 0. Okay. So in this case, you will find, when you will consider v equal to 0, so in this case you will find x double dot equal to 0, y double dot equal to 0, and also z double dot equal to 0. And similarly, if you will write the expression x equal to a t plus b, where a and b are constant, simply you can write y equal to c t plus d, where c and d are constant, and z equal to, suppose you will write f t since here the energy may be right, you will write E, then this will be Ft plus suppose some G, then here F and G are also constant. Okay, so these are the expression for your free particle when you will consider V to be 0, that is the potential energy to be 0, or in general if you will consider the potential energy to be mgz, so the expression will be like this. This is all about your Lagrangian application to a particle falling freely under gravity, and also for the free particle when you will consider the potential energy to be 0. If you have any doubt, can ask me in the comment section. If you like the video, hit the like button, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.